Well, I am really psyched to bring on our session leader. Elizabeth Sherman is an executive health coach who works with executives, entrepreneurs, and top performers to improve their health through simple, easy-to-sustain lifestyle habits and skills. She helps her clients design the right health program for their lifestyle with the idea that we can all achieve optimal health, which of course leads to better performance at work and improved focus and of course leadership. She's a Chicago native, but now conducts her coaching business in Mexico. And with that, welcome, Elizabeth, to the ExecuNet stage. They are all yours.
Thank you, Tony. What a great honor. I am so excited to be here today. Thank you, everyone, for being here. What we're going to talk about today is how to look and feel your best when you are working, as well as when you are conducting your job search. So you are in the right place if you are looking for a new role or will be sometime in the future, which is probably all of us. You want to look and feel confident when you're meeting employers. And you know, who doesn't want to look and feel confident? Because that's one of the things that attracts people to us. And you're probably in the right place if you're like most of us and self-care hasn't been your priority in the past. And as we get older, we start to feel, you know, the universe knocking on our shoulder saying, hey, you need to start paying attention. Or you just have a desire to make a change for the better. So if you're here, you've probably signed up for this training because you're looking for a change. And, you know, you're probably, if you're actively looking for a new job or a new role, you're probably realizing that searching for a new job is pretty stressful. Is my resume good enough? Or why aren't they calling me back? Why didn't they like me? I thought we were a great fit. And, you know, then there's all of this anxiety around, I'm never going to find another job, or if I do, it's not going to be what I want. So there's tons of anxiety and stress that go along with searching out for a new job. And so hopefully within this presentation, I will help you, combat some of that and give you some strategies that you can take that will automatically make this at least easier and less stressful. Because there's so much anxiety and stress in not knowing. So, you know, I know that, you know, even though I am an entrepreneur, I did start out in, you know, the corporate world, and I was a vice president of you know, sales. And, you know, I've been through the job process and it's one thing to actually go through it. But the part that's really stressful is the not knowing. So here's what we're going to learn today. So what diffuse thinking is and how it can profoundly impact your job search, your career, and your life as a whole. How your health habits, your sleep, stress, eating, and movement, those are the things that we're dealing with here, can actually improve your creativity and confidence during your search. Why self-care isn't just for women. I think that self-care, that term, has such a, I don't want to say a negative connotation, but it has a PR problem. And so it's not just for women. And how I define it and why it's so much more than getting massages or manicures, pedicures, facials, and things like that. And then the signals that will tell you that you need to practice stress management. I think that none of us really realize until we really blow our top how much under stress we are. And so I'm also going to teach you three different techniques to help reduce anxiety. So if you stay to the end of the presentation, I do have a special gift for you. But one request for you. So be present. So eliminate distractions. Put your earbuds in. Grab yourself some coffee or your lunch or whatever it is that you have. You know, settle in. Please do ask any questions that you have. And then also, I would love for you to keep an open mind. And here's why. Because so often when we hear stuff, we automatically go to this place of, well, I already know that, or I've already heard that. And so what we really want to do is we really want to look at the information that I'm presenting today with an open mind and ask yourself, instead of I already know that, or I've already heard that, or I'm already doing that, ask, how can I apply this to my position? How can I use this in a different creative sort of way?